Because Disney Plus released the 7th season of The Clone Wars, I decided to go back and watch the first 6 seasons before jumping into the newest one. By episode 9, however, I found myself asking many questions raised by seemingly plot holes in the series. Chief among these questions, what exactly is Anakin Skywalker's rank in the Jedi Order? And why is it that Ahsoka Tano was familiar with Asajj Ventress when the dark side villain made her first appearance in the series? A quick web search showed that this was actually not Ventress's first appearance in the Star Wars universe, nor was this series the first to address the Clone Wars. Rather, there had been a prior series addressing the Clone Wars that aired between 2003 and 2005 on the Cartoon Network, directed by Genndy Tartakovsky. A quick look at internet images from the series sparked a vague recollection, but I did not remember the specifics. So I went on a quest to find and watch Tartakovsky's take on the Clone Wars. As I began my quest, I first noticed the series was not available through Disney Plus. This perplexed me. Since Disney bought Lucasfilms back in 2012, surely that included the rights to this Clone Wars series. Another quick internet search revealed that this was a mystery to numerous Star Wars fans. The most logical of the possible explanations speculated that Lucasfilms and the Cartoon Network developed the series jointly. Thus, the Cartoon Network likely still had a stake in the property, preventing Disney from making it available through the Disney streaming service. Fear not, the full 2-hour, 13-minute series was released on DVD and is available, new and used, on Amazon.com. And no, I do not get a kickback from mentioning Amazon. Even more exciting, as of the time I am writing this review, you can find the full series on YouTube. I am not providing a link to the series because it is easy to find and because I don't want to call the attention of any potential bot to it, which might result in its removal from YouTube. If you haven't already, you all need to see this. The Tartakovsky series doesn't pretend to be a kid's show. It grabs your attention with violent action almost immediately and doesn't let go. That, by far, is its greatest strength over the later Clone Wars series. Indeed, I can sum up the entire series in just one word. Badassery. The Tartakovsky series covers the timeline between the films Attack of the Clones and Revenge of the Sith. The series develops the plot of the Clone Wars to show us how we got from the introduction of the Clone Army to the Battle of Coruscant, where Obi-Wan Kenobi and Skywalker must rescue the captured Chancellor Palpatine from the clutches of the evil General Grievous. Since the Disney purchase of Lucasfilms, it is not considered Star Wars canon, which is disappointing because it explains, among other things, how Anakin Skywalker can have his own Padawan when the second Clone Wars series opens. Moreover, because Tartakovsky focuses on action instead of overly detailed dialogue and plot development, it leaves plenty of room to fill in the gaps creatively with more adventures of the Jedi Knights against Count Dooku's forces, such as the introduction of Skywalker's Padawan Ahsoka. The first thing I noticed was the fantastic quality of the animation. This is not computer-generated graphics. This series was hand-drawn in the style of Tartakovsky's other cartoon hits, like Samurai Jack. The series begins with a battle sequence, where the voice of Yoda briefly sets up the series with a summation of the situation facing the Republic. This battle sequence is every bit as exciting as anything Lucasfilms produced for the big screen. Tartakovsky next does an excellent job of laying the groundwork for the conflict that underlies the entire series, and no, not the one between the Republic and the Separatists. It is the conflict between Sheev Palpatine and the Jedi Order over the fate of young Skywalker. Throughout the series, Tartakovsky characterizes Anakin Skywalker as a brash, at times reckless, adventure junkie haunted by his aggression and anger. From Tartakovsky's depiction of Skywalker, we can see why Skywalker was so vulnerable to descend down the path of the dark side of the Force. The series depicts the villains as fierce adversaries, worthy of fear even from the Jedi Order. General Grievous, for example, isn't the caricature of the bumbling bad guy as he's depicted in the later cartoon series as well as in the film Revenge of the Sith. Rather, he is a ferocious antagonist, adept at hand-to-hand combat skills, including the wielding of a lightsaber. While we are used to seeing single Jedi Knights almost effortlessly handling multitude of battle droids, Grievous defeats groups of Jedis, fighting him simultaneously. Absent is the use of battle droids as silly comic relief. They are instead the deadly tools used by the Separatists to fight the Jedi and its clone army. Also absent is the insulting appeal to hormone-driven teenage boys. The female characters' breasts are not overemphasized like the later Clone Wars series. Nor do female characters don gratuitously revealing costumes, which is littered throughout the rest of the Star Wars universe. Now, there are some flaws to this depiction of the Clone Wars. Kenobi, for example, serves mostly to deliver one-liners and sarcastic remarks like a bad imitation of a James Bond movie. We don't get a sophisticated characterization of Kenobi like we do of Skywalker. Nor do we get much of a characterization of Padmé Amidala, other than to emphasize her love for Skywalker. In sum, Genndy Tartakovsky's depiction of the Clone Wars is far superior to the later cartoon series of the same subject matter. It lives up to the expectations created within the imagination of the wide-eyed six-year-old in me, created when I first heard Luke and Obi-Wan's passing reference to the conflict while hypnotized by the theatrical release of the first Star Wars movie. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to our channel. If you would like to receive notifications when we release other videos in the future, please click the button with the bell. Please leave a comment below. Thank you very much.